Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzo. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Wednesday, the 10th of March. Terror outfit Al Badr chief killed in encounter in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Myanmar police officers fled to India after flouting orders to shoot protesters, reports suggest. And PTI to utilize all options to ensure its candidates' victory as Senate chairman, says Pakistani minister. And now for all the details. Police in India's Jammu and Kashmir have identified the terrorist killed in an encounter in Sopore town on Tuesday night as Abdul Ghani Khwaja, the chief of Al Badr terror outfit, and termed his killing as a big success. A senior police official on Wednesday said an operation was launched at Tujjar Sharif in Sopore on Tuesday night after receiving specific inputs, leading to the elimination of Khwaja. The Al Badr chief went for training to Pakistan in 2000 and had returned to India in 2002. He was involved in several terror cases, including attacks on security forces and civilians, besides being the main recruiter, the official said. The police also said it busted two modules of Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Taiba outfits that wanted to carry out a major car bombing attack in Kashmir Valley.
यह पूरी सिक्योरिटी फोर्स दोनों के लिए बहुत बड़ी कामयाबी है क्योंकि ये लॉजिस्टिक सपोर्ट देने में पॉलिसी बनाने में किस पर अटैक करना है कहाँ मिलिटेंट को डिप्लेस करना है कहाँ रिसीव करना है इनका बहुत अहम इसका रोल था और मैं सोपुर पुलिस को और सिक्योरिटी फोर्स को मुबारकबाद देता हूँ कि बहुत अच्छा काम हुआ है बिना किसी कोलेटरल डैमेज का इतना बड़ा कमांडर मारा गया है.
As protests continue against the military coup in Myanmar, the police in the country have been instructed to shoot at protesters till they are dead, according to Reuters news agency. Reports suggest that many Myanmar police officers entered India to escape taking orders from the leaders in Myanmar.
When Tha Peng was ordered to shoot at protesters with his submachine gun to disperse them in the Myanmar town of Kampat on February 27, the police lance corporal said he refused. On March 1, 27-year-old Tha Peng said he left his home and family behind in Kampat and travelled for 3 days, mostly at night to avoid detection, before crossing into India's northeastern Mizoram state. Tha Peng is among the first cases reported by the media of police fleeing Myanmar after disobeying orders from the military junta's security forces. Around 100 people from Myanmar, mostly policemen and their families, have crossed over a porous border into India since the protests began, according to a senior Indian official as reported by Reuters news agency. Daily protests against the coup are being staged across the country, and security forces have cracked down. Meanwhile, Mizoram's Chief Minister Zoramthanga told Reuters that his administration would provide temporary food and shelter to those fleeing Myanmar, but a decision on repatriations was pending with India's federal government.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan will soon receive 45 million made in India coronavirus vaccines under the United Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization. Pakistan National Health Services has recently announced. India has supplied vaccines to 65 countries so far under three categories as part of the Global Vaccine Alliance in the form of grant or aid and through commercial sales.
Pakistan will be getting 45 million doses of Indian-made vaccine under the United Gavi Alliance, Federal Secretary National Health Services Regulation and Coordination, Amir Ashraf Khwaza recently informed the PAC, Public Accounts Committee of Pakistan. Global Alliance for Vaccines and Immunization, Gavi, is an international organization created in 2000 to improve access to new and underused vaccines for children living in the world's poorest countries. Gavi had signed an agreement with Pakistan in September 2020. Out of the total of 45 million by June 2021, Pakistan is to receive 16 million free doses of the Serum Institute of India, Oxford AstraZeneca's Covishield, which will cover 20% of Pakistan's population, noted Khwaza. India, one of the world's biggest drug makers, had on January 19 said it will send vaccines under grant assistance to several countries. An increasing number of countries have already approached it for procuring anti-coronavirus vaccines. In the latest, Pakistan reported 1,786 new coronavirus cases in 24 hours, taking the country's COVID-19 tally to 595,239, while the recovery rate is 95%. The country's death toll now stands at 13,324.
More news from Pakistan. The Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf Party will employ all political, democratic and legal tactics to ensure the victory of Sadiq Sajrani in the Senate chairman election, Senator Sibli Faraz said on Wednesday. The ruling party has endorsed Sajrani, the incumbent senator chairman, for a second term against opposition Yusuf Raza Gilani.
Pakistan's Minister for Information and Broadcasting, Senator Sibli Faraz, on Wednesday said that the ruling PTI, the Pakistan Tehreek-e-Insaf, will employ all political, democratic and legal tactics to ensure the victory of Sadiq Sajrani in the Senate chairman election on March 12. In a tweet, Sibli Faraz said the opposition is harming democracy by using illegal and immoral tactics, including sale and purchase of votes, and Prime Minister Imran Khan has a strong commitment of fighting against such practices. Meanwhile, the Islamabad High Court on Wednesday dismissed a petition filed by PTI challenging the March 3 Senate victory of senior Pakistan People's Party leader Syed Yusuf Raza Gilani, in which he outnumbered Finance Minister Hafiz Sheikh for a general seat from Islamabad, despite a comfortable majority of the ruling coalition in the National Assembly. The PTI had alleged that the opposition used money to influence votes. The 10-party opposition alliance Pakistan Democratic Movement earlier this week jointly fielded Gilani for the Senate chairmanship against PTI's Sajrani.
In news from Afghanistan, the Afghan Taliban is yet to finalize consultations about the US proposed draft peace plan, a local media report suggested on Tuesday. This comes as a senior leader of the militant group had recently expressed that moves by the United States indicate that Washington is serious about getting the Afghan peace process to succeed.
The Taliban is yet to finalize consultations about the US proposed draft peace plan, a local media report suggested on Tuesday. This comes as Mullah Abdul Salam Zahif, a senior Taliban leader, recently said that the recent moves by the US indicate that Washington is serious about getting the Afghan peace process to succeed. Meanwhile, officials on Tuesday confirmed that Russia is planning to hold a conference on Afghanistan in Moscow later this month, marking an attempt by the country to raise its profile in the Afghan peace efforts. Russia had said the talk scheduled for March 18 will bring together representatives of Russia, the US, China and Pakistan, as well as an Afghan government delegation and representatives of the Taliban. After keeping it aside, Russia has now also brought India on board with other countries to decide on the roadmap for Afghan peace.
Moving on to news from Nepal. Married women in Nepal, on the occasion of International Women's Day, participated in a unique marathon carrying their husbands on their backs to raise awareness about gender equality. Organized by local authority for very first time, the event saw participation of 16 couples from various age groups.
Aiming to raise awareness about gender equality, married women participated in a running event in Nepal, carrying their husbands on their backs. The event was held in the ground of a local school in Devghat Village Council of Tanahun District on the occasion of International Women's Day. Organized by the local authority on Monday, the marathon saw participation of 16 couples from various age groups and locality running the 100-meter race. Dozens of onlookers from around the village flocked into the playground of the school that is located nearly 150 kilometers away from capital city Kathmandu.
त्यसको खुशीयालीमा आज सारा यो प्रोग्राममा मैले पनि यो श्रीमानलाई बोकेर दौडिन नि भाग लिन आएको थिएँ हैन मेरो उमेर त एकदम धेरै भइसक्यो छ हजुरले मेरो त सुन्नु भएको छैन तै पनि म साहसको साथ गरेको सफल हुन चाहिँ सकिन अब खुशी छु अब महिलाहरूले रमाइलो गर्नुभयो सरहरूले इज्जत दिनुभयो
दुर्गा बहादुर थापा चीफ अफ देवघाट विलेज काउन्सिल सेड द गेम प्रोभाइडेड एन अपर्चुनिटी फर विमेन टु शोकेस देयर फिजिकल स्ट्रेन्थ इन कम्पेरिजन टु मेन
एउटा हामी छोरीहरू पनि अर्थात् हामी महिलाहरू पनि अर्थात् पुरुष जतिकै छौँ है भनेर चाहिँ एउटा चाहिँ आफ्नो चाहिँ भित्र एउटा क्षमता प्रदर्शनको लागि पनि यो चाहिँ खेल राखिएको छ त्यसले गर्दाखेरिमा महिला दिदी बहिनीहरू चाहिँ यसबाट चाहिँ केही सक्षमता अर्थात् उहाँहरूको चाहिँ केही हिचकिचाट उहाँ नियन्त्रण हुनेछ र उहाँहरूको चाहिँ केही सक्षमता पनि उहाँहरूको चाहिँ प्रदर्शन हुनेछ भन्ने मलाई लाग्छ
एभ्री पार्टिसिपेटिङ कपल वाज ह्यान्डेड सर्टिफिकेट्स एन्ड अप्लोडेड फर द पार्टिसिपेसन
The Indian Navy commissioned INS Karanj, a Kalvedi-class diesel-electric attack-style submarine, on Wednesday. This is the third submarine of its class that the Navy had received. The warship is equipped with a weapon package which can neutralize a significantly large enemy fleet despite its own small size.
Indian Navy commissioned INS. The Indian naval ship Karanj, a Kalvedi-class diesel-electric attack-style submarine, on Wednesday in the western port city of Mumbai. INS Karanj is the third Kalvedi-class submarine in an expected series of six under the program Project 75. It is a small 60-meter submarine with strategic deployment purposes. The warship is equipped with a weapon package which can neutralize a significantly large enemy fleet despite its own small size.
This is the third, tisri submarine which has been commissioned. The fourth one, Vela, is going through her sea trials. We have launched the fifth one and we are then thereafter going to go for the sixth one. So all six submarines of the P-75 now in a series manner, they will keep getting commissioned.
The Indian Navy had earlier inducted two submarines of the class named INS Kalvedi and INS Khanderi from the same shipyard.
Scores of Hindu ascetics held a grand procession and took holy dips as part of a royal bath ritual in India's Mathura ahead of Kumbh Mela or Pitcher festival. Devout Hindus believe that bathing in the waters of holy rivers absolves people of sins and at the time of Kumbh brings salvation from the cycle of life and death.
Hindu holy men held a grand procession on Tuesday and took dips in River Yamuna as they participated in the second royal bath ahead of the Kumbh Mela or the Pitcher festival in India's northern Mathura city. Usually throughout the duration of the Kumbh fair, the host cities witness nearly 100 million visitors, but this time the number has remained considerably low so far amid the coronavirus pandemic. Devout Hindus believe that bathing in the waters of the holy rivers absolves people of sins and bathing at the time of the Kumbh brings salvation from the cycle of life and death.
Aaj Ekadashi hai aur Ekadashi hone se is snan ka mahatmya hai. और स्नान के लिए हमारे तीनों अनी अखाड़ों ने संपूर्ण तैयारियां की हैं और बहुत ही सुंदर व्यवस्था से आज यहां पर सम्मिलित सबका स्नान संपन्न होने वाला है
The Kumbh fair will begin on March 11. Authorities have made it compulsory to present a negative coronavirus test result before joining the festival.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.